So one of the things you see here, it talks about discipline. But I believe that discipline is bringing us to something more important, which is the fact that God has children. And so the race that God is talking about in Hebrews chapter 12 is talking about a relationship with Him. A what? Okay, you guys are following. It is a relationship between the Creator Father and we His children. And so God has designed a race so that we can be His children and be connected to Him. And so as I begin to talk about these three aspects of the race that God has designed, we are going to begin to see that everything has to do with our relationship with God. And so the first thing in the race is the starting line. And so the starting line there talks about where we begin to have a relationship with the Father. Now, there is a difference between running and being in a race. Would you agree with me?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, before you get into a race, you train. And so you run up and down many times. But the fact you're running at that point in time does not mean that you're in a race. Right? When someone is training for the marathon or training for a long distance race, they run sometimes in the course of the marathon 2, 3, 4, 5 times. But the fact that they are running doesn't mean that they finish the race. Not at all. But until they get to the starting line, they've not started. Now, in the case of relationship with Jesus Christ, or relationship with God, the starting line is Jesus. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2 makes it clear. It says, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Let's put that up. Verse 12, chapter 12 verse 2. Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher. It says, the NLT version says, we do this by keeping our eyes on Jesus, the champion who initiates and perfects our faith. It makes it clear that our faith begins with Jesus. Our faith begins with what?
Jesus.
Now, the birth, death, and resurrection of Jesus is not in question. Was Jesus born? Did he live on earth and did he die? That is something that we don't have to bother proving. Even people who are not Christians know that as a fact. There is enough historical fact out there that lets us know that there was a man Jesus. There's enough historical fact out there that says this man Jesus was crucified. There's enough historical fact that's out there that says this man Jesus died on the cross. He was not taken down from the cross before he died. There are medical journals who have written on this fact that the man Jesus died. It is not a question. It is not a fable. It's not a story made up. There is history facts about Jesus. So the question is not did Jesus exist. But the question that most of us need to answer is what do I do with Jesus? Because until you can answer that question, you do not get to the starting line. Now, you can come to church and do all of that. But guess what? Until you answer the question, what do I do with Jesus, you don't get to the starting line. You can read your Bible, sing on the choir, make CDs. But until you answer the question, what do I do with Jesus, you don't get to the starting line. You see, some Muslims have decided that Jesus is a great prophet. And that's what they decided to do with Jesus. And in so doing, they miss out on a relationship with the Father. Because they refuse to accept Jesus as the starting line. He's a prophet, a great prophet, an awesome prophet. But he's not the initiator. He's not the one that we look to. For many Eastern religions, Buddhism, Hinduism, Jesus is a good and great teacher just like many others. And so they can pick and choose what they want from Jesus. They can decide if they want to follow this or if they want to follow that. But they still not answer the question, what do I do with the irrefutable facts of history that this man lived and died and rose again from the dead? And so they ignore all of that, and in so doing, they lose out on what God wants from them, a relationship with them. There are people who don't know about Jesus. You know, the saddest part for me is when I look at people who grew up in church. You grew up in church. You came to church Sunday after Sunday, went to Sunday school, became a teenager, came to the service. You can quote part of the scripture to people, but you never answered that question. What do I do with Jesus? The race we are talking about is a relationship with God. Unfortunately, many people turn to religion and tradition in attempt to get into a relationship with God. Religion and tradition will not get you there. God has set the race, and God has set Jesus at the beginning of the race. Krishna will not get you there. No matter what it is, no other person has said clearly that I am the way, the truth, and the life. Oh, you might be like, well, I just need to be as good as I want to be. That's not what Jesus said. That's not what God said. He said Jesus as the starting line. Unless you accept the death and resurrection of Jesus, unless you believe that Jesus removes your sin and makes you a part of the family of God, you have not started the race. And it's important that you start this race. You must surrender everything to God and love Him with all your heart, your soul, your mind, and everything. Until you get to that point, you have not begun the race. And so the other things I talk about in this message will help you understand what the race that you're trying to sign up for is all about. But you're not yet in the race. And if you don't start the race, you cannot get the